हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम चामला डेपे, लेक्चरर इन केमिस्ट्री, ह्यूमैनिटी एंड साइंस डिपार्टमेंट, एजी पटेल पॉलिटेक्निक इंस्टीट्यूट, सोलापुर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम इम्पोर्टेंट प्रैक्टिकल रिलेटेड क्वेश्चंस ऑफ अप्लाइड साइंस केमिस्ट्री। कोड इज 222202। सो लेट अस प्रोसीड फर्दर। डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ परसेंटेज ऑफ Fe from hematite ore using KMnO4, that is potassium permanganate, involves which type of titration? Okay, so here determination of percentage of Fe using KMnO4, it is the redox type of titration. You are knowing there are the various types of titration: redox titration, complexometric titration, iodometric titration, precipitation titration. Okay, so this determination of percentage of iron from hematite ore using KMnO4, it is the redox type of titration. In second semester we are having only titration, most of the titration experiments are there. Okay, so this experiment number 1, it is of redox titration. So what is the redox titration? Next question is, what is redox titration? Okay, the titration which involve reduction and oxidation reaction, it is called the redox titration. Both the reactions are involved, that is reduction reaction and oxidation reaction. That titration, it is called the redox titration. Next question, what is the atomic weight of Fe? Okay, as when you are going to do the calculation of the determination of percentage of Fe, we are writing one standard relation is there, that is 1000 ml one normal KMnO4, which is equal to 56 gram of, or which is equivalent to 56 gram of Fe. From where that Fe it is coming? It is nothing but the atomic weight of Fe. Okay, from periodic table it is determined. So it is 56 gram. Okay. Next, what is the role of zinc granules in the dissolution of hematite ore? Okay. During the practical we have seen how to dissolve that hematite ore, and during that dissolution sulfuric acid is added. After sulfuric acid we are going to add the zinc granules. So these zinc granules, they react with that sulfuric acid and evolve the hydrogen gas. This evolved hydrogen gas actually it is acting as a reducing agent. Okay, so what is the reaction? See, this is the zinc granule. This zinc granule, it is going to react with your sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4, and it gives zinc sulfate, that is ZnSO4, plus hydrogen gas is evolved. Okay, and remember one thing, in this experiment number 1, we need the iron Fe, it is in the +2 state. Okay, this hydrogen, what it is going to do, it is going to maintain the +2 state of the iron. Okay, if the solution consists of Fe3+ ion, ferric ions are there, it is reduced to the Fe2+. So zinc granule, they are added to evolve the hydrogen, and actually that hydrogen gas, it is going to act as a reducing agent. Next, which indicator is used in the determination of Fe from the hematite? Okay, in this experiment number 1, KMnO4, which is self-indicator, potassium permanganate, it is which is filled in the burette, itself act as the indicator, whose color is the pink color. Okay, so here it is the self-indicator. KMnO4, it is acting as a self-indicator. No need to add any external indicator in this. Okay, because KMnO4, it is itself acting as a indicator. What is the color of the KMnO4? Okay, the color of KMnO4, it is the dark pink color cap. Okay, next, what is the color change at the end of this redox titration? This redox titration means determination of percentage of Fe from hematite ore using KMnO4. Here we are KMnO4 itself acting as a indicator. Okay, so in the beginning your ore color or Fe ore sample solution, its color is colorless, and when you are going to know that the reaction is complete, so you are going to determine it from the end point. So color changes occurred at the end point, and its color change, it is the colorless to light pink. This is the end point for this redox titration. Light pink, it is the end point. So, colorless to light pink. Next, what is the formula of hematite ore? Formula of hematite ore, it is the Fe2O3. Okay, formula of hematite, Fe2O3. This is the formula of hematite ore. Next, determination of copper from the given copper ore involve which type of titration? Now, this is our experiment number second. Okay, this is also the titration experiment. But here, you are determining the copper from its copper ore. So, it is the iodometric titration. Here, you are using the starch indicator. Iodine is involved. Okay, when you are going to add the Ki, that time yellowish brown color, so it becomes the yellowish brown color. That time iodine is evolved, and that evolved iodine, it is titrated using sodium thiosulfate and starch as an indicator. Okay. Next question: reduction means, what is the meaning of reduction? Reduction means addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen or gain of electron. It is called the reduction. What is oxidation? Oxidation, exactly opposite of reduction, that is removal of hydrogen, addition of oxygen or loss of electron. It is called the oxidation. Let us proceed further. Name the indicator used in iodometric titration. Yes, here in experiment number 1, KMnO4 itself acting as an indicator. No external indicator is added, but in this determination of used in the iodometric titration. For this, like in experiment number 1, KMnO4 it is acting as a self indicator, but in experiment number 2, here starch it is used as a indicator. Okay, remember in this experiment starch it is used as a indicator. And mostly in all the iodometric titration, starch is used as a indicator. Next, what is the color change at the end point of iodometric titration? Okay, so what is the color change? Like previous one, it is colorless to light pink. So in experiment number 2, the color change at the end point, it is the blue to milky white. Okay, that is the color change in this iodometric titration. So, let us proceed further. Mention the type of reaction when cupric ion converts into the cuprous ion. As I said to you, cupric ion. Cupric means higher valency. Copper is having two valencies, Cu2+ and Cu1+. Okay. When cupric, it is converted into cuprous. So, plus 2 when it is converted into plus 1. That time one electron is gained, and you are knowing gain of electron, it is the reduction reaction. So see here, you can see it here, Cu3+ plus one electron is gained. Sorry, here something is wrong here. Cu2+ plus one electron is gained, that it is going to form Cu1+. Okay, that is the gain of electron. The above reaction is reduction reaction. Okay. Copper pyrite is which type of ore? Okay, you are knowing there are the various types of ore. Oxide ore, carbonate ore, sulfide ore. So, copper pyrite. Okay, sulfur is present. It is a sulfide ore. So, this is the sulfide ore. Next, name the hardness causing salts with formulae. Okay, mostly there are the 6 salts which are going to cause the hardness to the water. First is the calcium bicarbonate, formula of calcium bicarbonate, CaHCO3 twice, calcium carbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, calcium sulfate, CaSO4, magnesium sulfate, MgSO4, calcium chloride, magnesium chloride. These 6 salts, they are going to cause hardness to the water. Out of these 6 salts, about 2 salts, they are going to cause temporary hardness to the water. While these sulfates and chlorides of calcium and magnesium, they are going to cause the permanent hardness to the water. Okay, they are going to cause the permanent hardness to the water. Okay, so this temporary hardness, it is also called the carbonate hardness. Remember, during theory also we have covered this part. It is called the carbonate hardness, and permanent hardness, it is called the non-carbonate hardness. It is called the non-carbonate hardness. Next, name the salts causes temporary hardness to the water. Okay, just now I said to you, bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium, they are going to cause the temporary hardness to the water. Okay, so there are the two salts, that is calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate. Sometime examiner may ask you, write the formula of calcium bicarbonate. That time you have to write like this, CaHCO3 twice. This is the formula of calcium bicarbonate. Magnesium bicarbonate, MgHCO3 twice. Okay, so this is the magnesium bicarbonate. Next question, temporary hardness is also called, what it is called? Okay, on my previous slide also I have explained, temporary hardness, it is also called the carbonate hardness, because as they consist of this carbonate, okay, so it is called the carbonate hardness. Next question, name the indicator used in the determination of hardness of water. Okay, which indicator is used in determination of hardness of water? Erichrome black T, EBT, it is also abbreviated as EBT. EBT indicator is used in the determination of hardness of water. Next, which type of titration is involved in the determination of hardness of water using EDTA? Okay, here it is the complexometric titration. Remember, experiment number 1, it is the redox titration, that is determination of Fe from the Fe ore. Determination of percentage of Cu from Cu ore, it is the iodometric. Next, third, determination of hardness of water, it is the complexometric titration. Okay, EDTA, it is complexometric titration. What is the end point of complexometric titration using EDTA in hardness determination? Actually, this question is, what is the color change at the end point? Okay, color change, it is wine red to blue. Wine red to blue is the color change at the end point of complexometric titration. Next question, what is the color of EBT indicator? EBT, what is the full form of EBT? It is the erichrome black T. Though its name include black, it is not black in color, its color is blue. Remember, okay, the color of EBT indicator is the blue. What is the full form of EBT? Full form of EBT, it is the erichrome black T. Okay, though its name consists black, it is not black in color, its color is blue. Okay, now how temporary hardness of water is removed? Okay, during theory also we have covered, temporary hardness of water, it is removed just by boiling only. By mere boiling of water, temporary hardness is removed. Okay, non-carbonate hardness is another name of, okay, it is another name of permanent hardness. Permanent hardness, it is also called the non-carbonate hardness. Next question, hardness of water is expressed in equivalent of, always remember, in theory also, in board exam also, this question is asked with option. So, calcium carbonate equivalent. Hardness, it is always expressed in terms of equivalent of calcium carbonate, and its unit is ppm or mg per liter. This is the unit for the hardness determination, and it is expressed in equivalent of CaCO3. Okay, so all these are regarding the practical questions. Remaining question we will see in the part 2 of the same. Thank you.